The first film in Denis Villeneuve's two-part adaptation of Dune has finally arrived in most markets, with much acclaim from both critics and audiences alike. While the film's reception has been mostly positive from Dune fans, who have praised Villeneuve's faithfulness to the source material, there are still many who had hoped for more development of certain characters, as well as the establishment of certain key elements upon which this universe is founded. One of these elements that many fans wanted to see more of were the Mentat capabilities of both Thufir Hawat and Peter De Vries, which would emphasize why they are so valuable to the great houses they serve. Thufir Hawat is noted as one of the finest Mentats in the Imperium, feared by the Emperor himself, and Stephen McKinley Henderson, in my opinion, did a fantastic job portraying this character. I certainly would have loved to have seen more from him in the film. With a runtime of just over 2.5 hours, it's becoming apparent that a fair amount of footage had to be trimmed in order to fit within a more digestible length and format for general audiences. In this video, I'd like to discuss some points from a recent interview with Stephen McKinley Henderson, where he talks about a pivotal scene for his character, and one that was ultimately cut from the finished film. Spoiler warning for those of you that haven't seen the film yet. Henderson recently spoke with The Hollywood Reporter, where he revealed the process of his casting and his preparation for the film. During the interview, he was asked how he felt about Thufir Hawat's decision to tender his resignation after the failed Hunter-Seeker assassination attempt on the young Paul Atreides. He said, quote, "That's exactly the thing. That's something that never would have happened to him at a different point in his journey. And that was the other thing that made me realize he had served the grandfather. He had served Duke Leto's father. So he's been around a minute. And he was probably better at his job when he was less emotional about it, when he was less human, and when he wasn't as attached to them as he was. So his negligence endangered Paul. I don't know whether it's still in the film or not, but in the script that we had, Paul said to him, 'It was also what you taught me that made me triumphant over that Hunter Seeker.' So that's the only thing that helped him get off the hook. But that resignation was a sincere desire to say, 'Get someone else because I care that much.'" It's really nice to hear the actor's insights into his character, and I did feel that the council meeting immediately after the Hunter-Seeker incident was a little short. I am curious to understand why such a small but significant line of dialogue was cut from the finished product, and I'm not sure why Villeneuve chose to not highlight Paul's Mentat training and Howard's part in that. Though it may seem the near assassination of the Duke's son was negligence on the Mentat's part, he is still universally renowned for his skills. But I did appreciate the deep feelings the actor attributed to Thufir in regards to Paul, and how protective he was, as if he was his own son. Henderson noted this by saying, quote, "He's a very likable guy, and so it was easy to do the substitution there. I also have a son, my only son, and he's dear to me. So I know I would rather have a professional. Although I would lay down my life for my son, I would rather have somebody who would not have to lay down their life, but somebody who would take care of whomever was trying to harm him, rather than die doing it. So yes, I really felt that resignation, and was shamed by the way that Duke handled it. He knew that I was going to go back and do better, but the cards were stacked against us completely, because there was betrayal at the highest order from the very beginning. But we're getting into part two now, and I can't talk too much about that." The cards are certainly stacked against House Atreides, and while Dune Part 2 has been teased by Warner Media, production on the sequel hasn't been officially greenlit. But from Henderson's comments, it seems as if the Emperor will have a significant role in the follow-up film. Faithful to the novel, the Emperor's involvement in the Atreides' downfall is teased throughout Part 1, and though his influence is certainly felt, he doesn't come onto the scene until later in the story. Regarding the scenes that were trimmed, Howard's personal interaction with Paul in reference to his valuable training is just one of a number of scenes which were apparently cut from the theatrical version. Jason Momoa, who portrays the swordmaster Duncan Idaho, has revealed his desire to see the 4-to-5-hour director's cut of the film, wanting to get Villeneuve's entire vision for this adaptation. After seeing the film, it's even more clear that there were several moments featured in trailer footage or set photos that either were presented differently in the film or eliminated entirely. Henderson briefly touched on Villeneuve's process in post-production as well, saying, "It was a wonderful script, but they shot and edited a story, so there were a lot of things that they had to choose from, and Denis chose to make sure that that was visible and in contrast to the other things. So I'm just grateful, because directors have to watch over a performance. You can do a lot of things that never get seen in a film, you know? And Denis loves acting and actors. So he makes sure that everyone gets their contribution. He shines a light. I find that Denis is very generous. He's going to tell the story, so he has to trim what he has to trim. And you may lose something that you were in love with, but what he keeps is a way of compensating you or apologizing. So that's what's left of it, and it's quite enough. It's like he turned a long poem into a haiku, and I'm just glad that you noted it. Henderson clearly has a deep respect for the universe, his character, and Denis Villeneuve's process. I appreciate his comments, though I'm not sure I can agree that every character received a valuable contribution to this film. Having said that, Dune is a deeply complex universe. As Villeneuve has stated before, it's a story that takes its power in details. So it's certainly a monumental task to remain faithful to the spirit of Frank Herbert's work, while also making it accessible and enjoyable for general audiences, and in that respect I'd say he succeeded. Regardless, I doubt the calls for the release of an extended director's cut will die down anytime soon. Denis Villeneuve commented on the idea of a potential director's cut recently. In an interview with La Presse, the director stated, "It's true that if Joe Walker, the editor, and I had let go, we could have done a version of several hours because I filmed a lot. But the final version is really the one that ends up on the screen. I have never done a director's cut of any of my films." So while it's apparent there won't be an extended version in the likes of the Lord of the Rings trilogy, I am hoping we can, at the very least, see the deleted scenes as part of the extra footage that comes with the Blu-ray release of the film itself. Many of these scenes I feel would add so much to the development of the characters of Frank Herbert's carefully crafted epic, and would help the audience to really understand the weight and importance of each of these figures. If you'd like to read the full interview with Stephen McKinley Henderson, I'll leave a link in the description below. I highly recommend it as it further dives into his preparation for the role. Also, for more information on the Mentat Order, be sure to check out my lore video on the subject, where I dive a little deeper into these human computers. But I'm curious to know what you think of Henderson's and Villeneuve's comments about the extra footage that was left out of the film. Would you be satisfied with seeing the deleted scenes, or is a director's cut the only way to go? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did, and be sure to subscribe for more Dune and other sci-fi and fantasy news and lore. Thank you all so much for your support, and as always, have a very nerdy day.